Hey, everybody, this is Griffin McRae from Polygon.com here with Russ Frushtick, also from Polygon.com. Hi, Russ.
Hello.
And we are checking out
You have a robot hand.
Yeah, I do have one of those robot hands. This is Dishonored Death of the Outsider, the upcoming standalone DLC. It's weird. It's not really Dishonored 2 expansion. They are very much treating it as its own sort of separate thing.
And you can buy it standalone, right?
Right, yeah. So I got a chance to play it. This is me playing it at QuakeCon last week, and I wanted to show off some of the new stuff because I think they're doing some really interesting stuff with this sort of mini expansion game.
What's that teleport that you're doing?
So every character has a different teleport power, right? We had two different forms of it in Dishonored 2, and we're playing as Billy Lurk, who's a returning character, and her sort of motion power is Displace, where she sets down sort of a holographic version of herself that she can teleport to, which serves sort of the same purpose as a lot of the teleport powers have in the past, only you can use it to recall yourself to another place. This is, we're checking out, and this is going to be in the video a few times, this is my favorite thing in the whole game because it kind of changes the whole way you play it. This is called Foresight, and it is like a power that after messing around with it during my demo session, I can't believe it has never been in the game before. It allows you to sort of float around in this ghost mode and tag objects through walls that then you can see, and it also allows you to sort of mark where NPCs are on the map, and most valuable of all, see their vision cones once you pop out of that form.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, it's so helpful, and it's one of the most important things I feel like about the feel of Death of the Outsider is there were a couple powers that I didn't have access to in this demo, but I talked to Harvey from Arcane about sort of what they were going for, and it sounds like Billy isn't as powerful as Corvo was in Dishonored 1, or Emily was in Dishonored 2.
Yeah.
So a lot of the game is about sort of obtaining information and then using that information as practically as you
possibly
can.
So it's kind of closer to OG Thief gameplay.
A little bit,
Now,
she does have some tools that are really, really powerful that are going to be in kind of limited supply, and we'll see those a little bit later on. But her powers just aren't as... I never felt like a superhero while I was playing this. Instead, I had to be really, really smart about how I use things. So this is the other power that was available in the demo. You basically just Arya Stark the shit out of somebody.
No, that's not nice.
Well, they're unconscious, and while you have this mask, you appear as them in the world.
So dope.
So this kind of reminded me of the possession power from Dishonored. Only there are some really important limitations here. The first of which being that person whose face you took is still in the world, and if somebody sees their body on the ground, they will know that you are a fake, and so you have to be really, really careful about how you use it. You also can't use it if somebody's seen you, so you have to be really smart about it. So here I am using Foresight. I just went into this person's house. This mission involved going in to Karnaca and finding these two keys that I can use to unlock a vault that has a dagger that can apparently kill the outsider.
Okay.
I was just sort of dropped into this demo. That's kind of all I know about this world so far. And I tried to be stealthy up to this point, and it wasn't very good video, and so things start to get a little bit buck wild here. Here's a thing called the hook mine, which I attached to that person hoping something wild would happen, but he just kind of fell asleep on the stairs. But the hook mine's great because it just tears people towards it and knocks them out. Sticky grenade is, of course, back if you like doing this to people.
Oi,
yikes. And then you have a voltaic sort of launcher that you can use to sort of send different projectiles at people, including ones that set them on fire and stuff.
Sure.
So if you want to go loud, there are lots of ways to go loud. I didn't get very much footage of me doing those sick combos that you see in pro level Dishonored
videos.
Yeah,
you have to be pretty good at this game to know that stuff.
Yeah, well, this was unnecessary. It took me a while to get a feel for how to play as Billy, because when you play Dishonored, you kind of learn... This is the best, hook mine shit ever, by the way. When you play Dishonored, you kind of learn how to react to different situations.
She's,
and it takes a
while. By the way,
to,
an innocent person that does not deserve that. She was just working her job.
She's just unconscious. She's taking a ceiling nap. the hook mine is maybe my favorite thing in the game. It seems kind of overpowered, but apparently it's going to be in pretty limited quantities. I really, really liked what I played of this, because I really like that idea of being very prep focused, like, but not just charging into a room, because I really love the Dishonored games, but I can think of so many times that just, like, I turn a corner and there's a dude facing me, and then all of a sudden, like, my perfect stealth streak is broken.
Yeah, sure.
I also, as far as I know, there is not as much of an emphasis in Death of the Outsider on your actions sort of changing the like chaos level of the world, which is really I'm very excited about, because then, like, I don't necessarily feel like I have to be this perfect ghost.
Yeah, I'm sure there are achievements and stuff for people that care about that stuff.
Like, yeah, but it's not like the world is gonna change, as far as I know. That is the truth.
A lot of that in previous DLC. Now, again, not that this is necessarily DLC, but they've done some of that with story changes and stuff like that. Yeah. So I would be shocked. It's kind of integral, but...
Yeah, here's my little Home Alone trap that I set for... Yoink.
Oh, it's not quite a giant snake, but tarantula, but pretty close.
God, a giant snake would really change the tenor of that movie. Bone charms are, of course, back, and they can change sort of everything.
And the crafting and all that stuff.
Yeah, I didn't actually do any of it, but I mean, there is a crafted tab, but that was not really present in the demo. I felt like I really wanted to try to beat, like, this whole level, and I did not have very much time at all, so you'll see me here in a bit just start, like, rushing through it.
Yeah.
This was kind of a neat puzzle. I had to find the right audio tape thing, whatever they're called, to play that would open up that safe. So this is when the demo handler came to me and was like, hey, you have 3 minutes and then we have to kick you off. And I was like, uh-oh. Okay, let's go beast mode. There was a cult in this area called the Eyeless that very, very creepy. And I didn't get a chance to do this in my demo, but you can get contracts just in the world from merchants and the like who will give you like little mini assassination missions. Like in while you're playing with certain rewards.
For connoisseurs, he said.
Seems like there's a lot of tools for people who do want to play non-lethal. Like the concussion grenade and hook mine are both really valuable for like knocking folks out.
Yeah.
Or the electric.
Let me ask before we wrap up. Did you see anything that like Dishonored 2? I thought had like a few like very tentpole-y, super impressive, like totally unique levels, like the Clockwork Mansion, and
later on
with the heart. Was there anything that like? Visual, like in terms of environments, like really stood out as completely different, because this looks pretty similar to the places we've been.
I didn't really check anything out like that felt particularly unique. Again, this is in Karnaca, which is an environment that we got to explore in Dishonored 2, and there's some changes obviously, but there's probably some stuff like that in the game, but this was a very, you know, straight up and down sort of going to the city.
Learning how she plays differently in an otherwise familiar environment. Yeah,
yeah, and there's stuff to do, like, all over this level, and I kind of rushed it because I wanted to see what the end of it was like. So I had just, like, a couple of minutes here. This is, by the way, pretty great.
Oh,
they're just knocked out again. They're totally fine. these people are not going to be as great. I'm really hoping that stuff is in the game because, again, like that is some of my favorite stuff from Dishonored 2. Obviously, like the Clockwork Mansion level was sick as hell, and the like time travel level was really cool.
Yeah.
But really, like, what stood out to me and what got me really... this was not really on my radar, really, as much as I enjoyed the Dishonored games. It just, like, was not something I was really anticipating. That was also unnecessary.
nice.
It was not something that I was really anticipating, but this way of playing, this feel of, like, being completely prepared to go into a room and sort of know what your battle plan's going to be before you get into it, I feel like it's going to be, like, really... great for like how I like to play these games. I like to play through them perfectly, although this footage is not really great evidence of that. I like to go through and be stealthy and not let anybody see me and make sure that I feel like I have like done the smoothest shit possible at all times. And that foresight power is really cool for that. The semblance power is really cool for that. That is all that I played. I almost made it back to the ship here and won, but then I missed that. So
sad.